Get mantra and meditation MP3s at jasongallant.ca.
Thoughts aren't who you are. If they were, you would cease to exist the moment you stop thinking. You can watch this video right now without thinking or with thinking a lot of stuff. Each will have a very different experience. One is an absolute immersion into this moment, and the other is just a mix of a bunch of things floating around in your mind and somebody speaking on a screen to you. But there is nothing happening in that. It's just the noise of that vehicle going by. It's just a bunch of noise. But in this spiritual path, or this enlightenment journey, you're asking, what is the truth? What is the deepest, most meaningful experience I can have? And what are the technicalities around that? How do I achieve this? Well, one thing I can tell you for sure is that you will not achieve it through thinking. It's the never-ending merry-go-round of thinking which causes the problem in the first place. This is which causes the suffering that you experience. Thinking creates a veil between you and reality. You're too busy projecting what to see instead of truly seeing. It's a big filter which diminishes the overwhelming experience of this moment, the overwhelming beauty of it, this infinite experience that is with you at all times. You've just distracted yourself from it. That's the greatest realization on the enlightenment journey, is that you don't earn anything, really. It was already given to you. It's already here. The moment you choose to let your thoughts go, to not give them so much weight, and if you're wondering what the splashing water is, that's a bunch of salmon spawning behind me. Which brings me to another thought, ironically. Thinking is not the same as creating. Taking a great painting or some sort of Mona Lisa of some sort and putting a mustache on it is not the same as something emerging from deep within. It just flows out. No thinking. It just is a happening that happens within you, such as giving birth or even being born. You didn't have a lot of input from the thought point of view about your own birth. It just happened. So one of the reasons why people who are in or on the path to enlightenment, one of the reasons why they end up becoming so creative is not because they start thinking more. It's actually the opposite. once they stop censoring and suppressing everything, creativity naturally happens. There's this giving birth to yourself. Over and over again, there's this birth of life, like the Brahma aspect, and then there's the going inwards. There's this natural death process that happens. Just like the salmon right now, they're giving birth. They're laying eggs right now to give birth to new salmon, and then they will die. It's this cyclical process that continues. It's the natural way of you. Through this deep allowing, there will be many natural ways of you that you'll become aware of, but they have very little to do with thinking. You're not thinking this to happen. You will just start to observe this naturalness that happens. I'm not saying you won't think altogether. Of course you will think, but you will not be dominated by thinking. Thinking will be used by who you are, not your thoughts using you. Imagine a ventriloquist with a dummy. The ventriloquist is telling the dummy what to say, but imagine it was the other way around. The dummy telling the ventriloquist what to say. That's really what happens when people are dominated by their thoughts instead of who they truly are. I found many people fear themselves. They say, geez, if I'm not thinking, who will I be? What will I be? Doesn't it make sense to let the intelligence tell you that? The intelligence that gave birth to you? If the grand intelligence of this universe knew how to give birth to you, it makes a lot of sense that this grand intelligence also will guide you towards where you should be or where you are supposed to be in your life, and also how you should experience it. At some point on your spiritual journey, you will have to surrender to something grander than your ego and your thoughts. It's tremendously freeing, and it's not naive. Some people think it's naive. They say, no, I want to keep control. I don't want to believe in any mommy and daddy of the universe or somebody to take care of me, but that's not scientific thinking, really. There is a natural harmony that happens through all of life and all of nature. And there is a nature within you, and when you allow it, a greater harmony bursts forth. Free from condition. Free from suffering. And it's amazing what happens with a human being when they are free from their own constriction. Life happens. Life of many flavors. But no matter what is happening, there is an experience of you that is with you through it all. And that is really what you're after. the experience of you or self, that the mind has disconnected you from. So if you're not a devotion person, you think all spiritual teachers and gurus are full of crap, at least devote yourself to your truest self, the one beyond your mind, the one beyond the limitations that you think you know. And during times of suffering, this will be your exit door. The salmon agrees. So I hope this helps you on your spiritual journey. Take care for now.
Are you interested in working with a spiritual teacher in a formal setting? Well, perhaps the Wisdom Life School is for you. If you're interested in checking out what the Wisdom Life School is all about, just go to aratima.com.